Philippine gaming regulator PAGCOR and the local government of Porac, Pampanga trading blame over illegal pogos in the town. Porac Mayor Jaime Capil earlier accused PAGCOR of failing to monitor the Lucky South 99 pogo hub, where evidence of human trafficking, torture, and scam activities were found. But for PAGCOR, Porac officials should have noticed the illegal activities happening within the hub.
Kansilado na po ang permit yan. Nakapagtataka rin, paano nabigyan pa ng business permit noong 2024 yan kung wala na silang maipakitang lisensya na valid na nagmumula sa PAGCOR. Ang estilo po sa Porac, estilo rin sa Bamban. Yung pinagkalooban ng lisensya ay wala doon sa pangkasalukuyang 46 na building. Imposible hindi niya nalalaman na 1,000 ang foreign nationals na nagtatrabaho roon.
PAGCOR also warning against calls to totally ban pogos.
Pagka po basta diniklarang illegal yan, lahat, pati ho yung lehitimong may lisensya, ang paniwala ko po tutuloy po ang hanap buhay niya mga yan illegally. Ang ibig sabihin ko hindi po mapipigil na yung mga yan dahil wala na pong pupuntahan yung mga foreign nationals na yan. Kaya po ang pinakikiusap ko, yung lehitimong may lisensya, kayaan natin maghanap buhay ng tama. At dyan naman, ang pamahala nating pangnasyonal ay nag-generate ng napakalaki rin namang kita.
These two poll watchdogs now gearing up for the 2025 elections. And as Sherian Torres tells us, youth volunteers are also preparing to play their roles in guarding the vote.
Ayan, so ito yung, the National Citizens Movement for Free Elections, or NAMFREL, is once again stepping on its accelerator to recruit youth volunteers in time for the 2025 elections. The 40-year-old organization kicks off its training program with an initial 15 youth volunteers, all aiming to help ensure an honest, transparent, and orderly elections. Among them, 16-year-old Jasmine Encarnacion, who wants to follow the footsteps of her father, who is also a NAMFREL volunteer.
It was also a personal decision of mine. I want to be an active citizen. I want to know anything or more about my country, about what's going on. And so at that thought, I said na, can I join you?
20-year-old Mary Ann Caparoso says she joined NAMFREL with a goal to guard vote-buying activities.
Kabataan po, kailangan namin na insecure na mga botante po ng mga kabataan ay protektado. Tapos, hindi po siya maloloko po, opo, mapapaikot po ng mga kandidato po.
Meanwhile, political science student Alex Caubajero says his parents support his decision to advocate for clean elections.
Living in a democratic country, yung suffrage yung isa sa pinaka dapat mas most practice na rights natin sa Pilipino. So parang ako bilang isang estudyante, bakit ko naman hindi i-take yung opportunity to be a volunteer sa ganitong klase ng organization?
NAMFREL National Chairperson Lito Averia points out no one can discount the significance of youth participation in their advocacy for change. And every youth volunteer, he says, plays a significant role in NAMFREL's programs.
Nagde-deploy kasi kami ng mga volunteers sa mga voting centers, and if possible, kung marami-rami, doon sa polling place mismo, doon kung saan bumuboto, to observe nga yung procedure, yung processes on election day. Kung meron tayong volunteers din on the ground na mag-o-observe yung packaging halimbawa ng mga balota from the NPC, tapos sasabihan natin yung volunteer naman doon sa lugar, no, kung saan dadalhin yung balota, nakakahanda rin sila, makita nila yung delivery.
Averia says only volunteers of legal age are deployed in the field, while those below 18 will serve their operations center. Those who would like to volunteer, he says, can either visit their website or approach the NAMFREL's local chapters. Meanwhile, LENTE, or Legal Network for Truthful Elections, which focuses on legal poll issues, has opened a social media platform to dissect concerns related to the Filipino vote. In LENTE's Ang Show Na Walang Title podcast, three veteran journalists examine Commission on Elections Chairman George Irvin Garcia's plan to ban artificial intelligence, or AI, and deepfake technology use in the 2025 campaign.
Ang laking bagay if we pre-bunk or inoculate or educate our audiences. We have a very young population. Tapos every election, there are a new set of young voters. So there needs to be an effort na tulungan sila maintindihan yung mga bagong technology at palakasin yung kumbaga yung resistensya nila to misinformation.
Walang ibang solusyon dun kundi education. We need informed and empowered citizenry.
The Commission on Bank, meanwhile, will soon decide on the proposed posting in the COMELEC website of the Certificate of Candidacy or COC and Certificates of Nomination and Acceptance or CONA of all 2025 elections. This is to ensure that those who will be caught lying about their COCs in the future will be charged accordingly. Sherian Torres, ABS-CBN News.